point, at that point, maybe the music media was still in thrall of post-war Anglo-American rock and roll, and that maybe a very monocultural outlook on music and youth culture. I suppose you're influenced culturally by things that have been created by in a certain language. So before the Act of Union, you know, between Wales and England, for example, there was certain Welsh laws. For example, sharing something. The law was that one person shares and then the other person chooses. You know, so it's a way of making sure that things are done fairly. But then, instead of being a law, it's just become a commonplace idiom. You know, so if you're chopping up a cake, you don't chop a cake and give someone a piece of it. You chop the cake and then you offer it, and then the other person decides, oh, yeah, I'm going to have the bigger one. You know, like, but you know, you're likely to cut it pretty forensically. Dead at 50%, you know. A record like Ratton and Edlaith, which was a solo record, and also was involved with a Welsh language album called Mum with the Super Animals. Both those albums are sung in the Welsh language. Musically, they're influenced by the language of New York chunky music from the 1960s. So the languages can help each other out. It's by giving languages and cultures new ideas. I suppose that's the importance of keeping diversity, linguistical diversity.